Hmm. Look at that guy. Commander Xenon? His forte. Hush. Pretend to be unconcerned, McBain says. Jan, come on. You're doing a good job. Oh, poor Jan. It bothers me, says McBain. Should we sneak in, says Forte. Woof! Why are you mad? Forte says. Woof! It's playing with the dog's emotions. I am the commander of the Empire Army, Xenon. You must be the president of the Meritos Group. I'm so honored to meet you, and didn't expect you to be so beautiful. That's a nice compliment. Haha. But how come such a high-ranking officer of the Empire like you has come to Kavaro, looking over things before the invasion? Oh, no way! My purpose to visit Martros this time is on a goodwill mission. Besides, I'm interested personally in the special concert at the International Theater. What a commendable purpose you have. But how do you explain the incident on Riotam Island you set up? Because of Rish and Ambassador Bereger of your kind, I was about to have become a hostage. Oh, it's a misunderstanding. First of all, Ambassador Borrego doesn't even exist in my country. According to the follow-up investigation, a man named Slade was proven to also be an imposter. I guess suspicious people are working behind the scene without us knowing. However, it's our fault that the name of our country was used in a wrong deed, so I'm here to apologize. Meritos says, oh, you have a sincere attitude, unlike what I hear from rumors. Rumor has it that this beautiful city of art has been threatened by the wood soldiers recently, he says. I bet you're very worried since the special concert is coming soon. I can order my army to get rid of them all, if you like. You have a nose for news, she says. But it's not my judgment whether we borrow your help or not. It's the authority of Mayor DeMille. Why don't you go to the city hall and ask him? It's not there. You're so humble to say you don't have any authority. You're good at brown-nosing, she says. But don't take me lightly. I have been able to make this group this big because I can distinguish what's bad. Please leave for today. Good. Don't forget that I'm on your side. Excuse me. He's leaving, says Forte. That was unusual dialogue there. Just making sure they leave. McBain says, I didn't think the commander himself would venture in. But it looks like the first battle is a draw game. Good job. Oh, were you listening? Says Meritos. What am I going to do with you guys? Anyway, I didn't expect that they would start acting this first. From them, says McBain. Right. That means they must be pulling some wires on Mayor DeMille's side, too. It's good timing. Can I ask you a favor? Can you go to the city hall to see what's going on? I bet something interesting is happening there. Something interesting, says Una? Hmm, says McBain. Okay, Grandpa, let's go to the city hall. Close the door. Anything else? Go to the city hall or you will be able to see burlesque. What? If we don't go to the city hall, we see burlesque? Oh, you mean instead of the great concert? I could do some burlesque. Same thing. See if these people downstairs say anything new. Hopefully not. I'll just run to the hall if they do. Say old stuff. Alright, he doesn't get it. I heard that the ugly monsters appeared near Kavaro. I hope they're not going to invade the town. Yeah, he said that before, right? Nothing to wow about. That's funny. That customer looks scary. I knew someone with a high rank would come from Numeros, but I didn't expect it to be a military man. Is he here for the special concert? Alright, we're gonna head this way. Same thing. Same. Gotta get behind the place. Just leaving? Yeah, he's not here. How come Commander Xenon is here? Says Forte. Miss Maritos told him to come here, that's why. Weren't you listening? So this is what she meant, says Una. Nick Bane says, let's go talk to Mayor DeMille and ask him what's going on. Come on. Oh, he's back? Commander Xenon of the Numeros Empire looks very scary. Talk to these people. Same. He's in there. He is in there. After the Mayor DeMille came back, Commander Xenon came to visit him with precise timing. Isn't that a little suspicious? Maybe he's working with DeMille. DeMille wants to overthrow the town for himself, and then he'll be president. Even Commander Xenon of Numeros Army has come to Kavaro. Since such a high-ranked officer came here, things are going to get worse. Undoubtedly. Hi there. I just had a surprising guest here. What was he? Was he surprising? Yeah, we saw him outside, says McBean. I didn't expect Commander Xenon of Numeros Empire would come visit me. You sure about that? Excuse me for asking this, but what did he want from you? Says McBean. As a matter of fact, according to Commander Xenon, the Maritos group is plotting an ambitious smuggling. He's sowing dissent. It's laughable. Miss Maritos and I are squabbling friends. I know more than anyone she's not that kind of person. Good. But he offered to get rid of the wood soldiers on the roads, so I responded properly. But if you think of it, it's an outrageous story. McBain told him that Commander Xenon also visited Miss Maritos. I see. That means Commander Xenon is trying to worsen the relationship between us, insinuate himself in either of us, and gain the right to speak in Kavaro. I pretty much suspected something like that, though. Wow, says Una. Both you and Ms. Maritos are keen. I'm good at deceiving because I've got good training against Ms. Maritos. Some ill-mouthed people talk about us and say it's a fight between a cat and a dog of Kavaro. Don't worry about us. Our relationship is not something that will be destroyed by a trap of the military men. A cat and a dog of Kavaro, huh? That's a good point, says McBean. Oops, excuse me. That's okay. It proves that citizens call us that because they understand how we are to each other. It's a good thing. McBain says, well, the problem is why the Numeros all of a sudden fixed an eye on Kavaro these days. They're acting as if they were to have Kavaro their frontline base. DeMille says, setting the relationship between me and Ms. Maritos aside, I'm anxious about Numeros' intention. By the way, how is it going with Captain Palman and his camp in the swamp? Forte says, I see. If we ask Captain Palman directly what Numeros is plotting, we may be able to find out easily. Okay, shouldn't we tell them the contents of the notes, the letters as well? Una says, but Captain Palman is also someone from Numeros. Do you think he will talk to us so easily? I guess it depends on how you approach him, says McBean. As far as I observe, Captain Palman and his men in the swamp are not rotten. I think they're the kind of guys who will straighten the problem out if something unjust is being done in Numeros. If we talk to him heart to heart, he'll be straight with us too. Then please, I ask you as well, says Mayor DeMille. Under normal conditions, I should be going to meet Palman directly, but it's going to be a trouble if Commander Xenon gets suspicious. May I ask you to do so? Good idea, says McBean. Since we have no direct connection with Kavaro, it won't be a problem if we act. Captain Palman may be back in the swamp. Let's go check and see.
I don't want to go back to the swamp.
Kavaro is the center of economy and art. Even though Numerus is coming to no good and actually carrying out their conspiracy, the other countries wouldn't be quiet. I'm sure Commander Xenon knows that too, so please find out from Palman what Xenon is up to.
Alright.
Is there another Kavaro Times? Let's see if any books added. Doesn't seem to be. Through issue 4? Nope, still issue 3. Okay. These days it seems hectic inside the Embassy of Numeros. I guess it's because Commander Xenon came. I don't welcome the soldiers because the atmosphere of the city turns sterner when many soldiers are in town. Well, she says something new now that the mayor... let's just see if these people say anything. Oh, I would love to go to the Royal Library. Yeah, sleep between the books. That's the same. Since Mayor said he wanted to concentrate on the countermeasure of the monsters, I've got more stuff to do because of him. Is he telling me to die or something? I can't wait for the concert to start. Only Teodora is my oasis in the heart. That rhymes. Composing poetry now? So some people have new things to say. So we're supposed to find him where? Oh, back in the swamp, right? I'm trying to block it from memory. I mean, it's only halfway. It's not going to be as easy as trying to find a lightning shrine. It's not going to be as hard as trying to find a lightning shrine, is what I meant. It's all the same. Go thank your own ancestors. The smell of something baking started to flow in the air. It stimulates my appetite, says McBean. It smells like chestnut bread, says Forte. No doubt, Una says. You came at a good time, says Headman Matthew. Alto's just baked chestnut bread for his practice. Why don't you try some? Let's see, says McBean. Let me have a bite, too, says Una. They had a mouthful of chestnut bread that Alto's baked. Delicious. Yeah, says Forte. It's warm and crispy. I'm surprised. It is good, says McBean. All right, Alto says. What a boy, Matthew says. I only taught him a little bit of know-how on how to make chestnut bread, and he could bake such a good bread. All right, I'll sell your chestnut bread at the shop starting tomorrow, Altos. Go prepare for it. Yes, says Altos. Altos looks so excited, Forte says. Una says, I bet he must be so happy that he received boss's recognition. No, he loves the smiling faces of the people who eat his bread more than anything, says Matthew. He has a promising future. Altos may be able to create bread which will surpass my chestnut bread in the future. Alright. Alright, let's make a lot of delicious bread. Okay, he's busy making the bread. We'll continue looking around the town, see what might be new. You don't think if someone has something new to say, they should have this bubble? Otherwise, if it's the same thing that you've already seen, the bubble should be missing. The little happy smiley bubble. Maybe in Trails of the Sky they did that. Oh! That girl, yeah, she probably doesn't say anything new. Oh, what about... Where am I? Oh. Yeah, some people here I missed. Same. Okay. Are these dignitaries still in here? Every service of the Embassy of Numeros is currently suspended because Commander Xenon is staying over. Come back later. Alright. That's a little different from what he said before. Okay. Are we done with this map? I think we're done with this map. Peek around in here. But there was a fourth person. See if these people have any more insights. Yep, okay. Oops. I can't control myself. They're in here. Yeah. All right, they didn't have anything new, so slowly working our way out of the town, back to the swamp. The most attractive girl in Kavaro may be the female president of Merito's group. She is simply beautiful, cheerful, and mature. She has a charm that young girls don't have. I'm remembering wrong. I thought he had a crush on one of the theater performers, the concert artists, performers, whatever. I didn't realize it was Meritos herself. Yeah, that or I just forgot. We'll check in with Meritos last. See if these people in these houses have anything new to say. That's the same. What's he say? Stuck up. Yeah, except we're wandering around and we don't see these soldiers at all. I figured see some of them just standing around or something. I saw an important-looking man entering the embassy of Numeros. Was that Commander Xenon? He looks scary. Yeah, I read that one. Good job. Related to music. Alright, good. Did Maritos come back up here? Yep. How did it go in the City Hall? They told her about Commander Xenon visiting the City Hall. That's what I thought. Now that I'm interested in how Mayor DeMille responded to Commander Xenon, if possible, I would want Commander Xenon's soldiers to get rid of the monsters on the roads for free. But I don't want to owe them anything. It's a difficult decision. It's getting more interesting. I'll drop by the City Hall later. Alright. Back to the swamp for us. It's a swampy life for us, It's a swampy life for us. Whoops. Alright. The enemy is surprised. I'm not gonna use my power thing on them. Missed. Did not miss. 57. 82. Alright. This one's more damaged than the flower. Missed. Oh, they got 3 full meters. Wow. Nice. Leveling up to 18. McBain and Una. The other two are 4 and 6 points away. Okay. to a save in. Been a while. I wish I could press the up arrow to get to the bottom. This is our third time to this godforsaken place, and I hope it's gonna be our last. This is how they make the game longer. Keep making it going back to the same place. But this is the longest game of the Legend of Heroes games. Alright, where are these soldiers? Are they on this screen, or did we... I think they're here. And we have to move... You have to take this way, I think? Not really. Okay. Okay. What a fool! Yelling... Palman yelling? I'm not sure he's talking about... or to. This can't be happening. He looks very angry, says Fortan. There must be something serious going on, McBain says. Seriously foolish? Gray says, Captain, what did Commander Xenon say? Read this. Well, let's see, says Gray. Oh, gee. He refused to change the plan to arrest the girl, huh? And... Rocco says, and he says they can use force and hurt her if necessary. Rattel says, what up? Palman says, Rocco, Rattel, she's still there, right? Yes, says Rocco. Rattel says, she doesn't seem to go anywhere so far. Good, let's take her into protective custody. Captain, says Gray, are you sure that's the right thing to do? Don't take it wrong. I'm going to protect her. I'm going to go protect her. They're like, hmm? I dismiss you from your duty right now. I'll run out on my duty, take her into protective custody, and let her escape so that Commander Xenon won't be able to catch her. I do this on my own responsibility. You can do whatever you want. That's our captain, says Gray. Gray tore up the command letter. Hey, I want to read that. Unless it's the same one we've already read. Rattel says, I'll follow you to the nethermost hell. I will too, says Rocco. Thank you, everyone. Okay, let's go get Arya before Commander Xenon does. Huh. Dorku yelling, Captain Palman! What is it, Dork? Ooh. The north of Swamp Road is covered with the wood soldiers. The north of the swamp road, where we just came from. What? Says Palman. Kavaro is in danger. We're going to wipe out the wood soldiers, says Palman. Aye, sir. And off they go. Let's go! Going that way. Oh, we're in the tent. The wood soldiers? Says Una. McBain says, it's possible they were the ones we fought in Edel. It's worth giving a helping hand to Captain Palman now. Grandpa, let's go follow them. Alright. Was there anything else to do? Nothing interesting to find in the tent? Alright. So they went... They took this bridge. And then they must have took this bridge, unless they went swimming. Oops. And then they had to take this bridge, and then this bridge. So they're headed for the North Road, which is... Oh, we can go that way, I guess. Well, really the monsters want to fight them, but not us. Too bad we couldn't actually follow them. That would have been helpful. Saving again. Clickety click. We are here to lend a helping hand. I'm just walking right through it. Forte says, these are the same ones we saw in Edel. How come they are here? Una says, do you think Captain Palman's unit beat them out? Oh, are those destroyed? I mean, I thought we were just going to start fighting them. McBain says, where on earth did the captain go? Okay, these are... yeah, these are, like, destroyed wood soldiers. Not used to enemies sticking around after they're defeated. I guess they only explode if we kill them. Dun, 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 dun. I like this theme. Forte goes, ah! Woof! Jan barking. Captain Palman! How awful, says Una. Captain Palman has suffered multiple wounds on his whole body. Captain! Says Forte. Forte! It's too dangerous here. Leave here as soon as possible. The wood soldiers are on their way to attack here. How are the rest of the unit? McBain says, I think they're okay. It doesn't look like anyone is seriously hurt. I guess they're all unconscious? I mean, that's pretty serious, isn't it? Good. You protect them with your life, says McBain. Don't speak anymore. I don't think I can survive with these wounds. Right? Mr. McBain. No, says Una. Just heal him. I know my body. Okay. Strange thing to say. Grandpa, do something. McBain shakes his head, frowning. It is all I deserve. I did some terrible deeds, telling myself it was for my homeland. Now I must face the punishment. Listen. It's the girl. Oh, is she gonna come heal him? We can't heal him, I guess she can. What's going on? My wounds and my pain are going away. I can't believe this, says McBain. The deep wounds closed up. Miss Arya must be somewhere closer, says Una. It's Arya, Palman says. McBain says, I don't feel her presence anymore. She's gone. Arya. Why did you save even someone like me? McBain says, even though you're better thanks to Arya's power, you should have complete bed rest. Don't push yourself. Don't worry about Ms. Maritos and Mayor DeMille. We'll take care of it. You know everything, huh? Says Palman. Their plan was to pit Ms. Maritos and Mayor DeMille against each other and lose the citizens' trust so that they could catch them off guard. The Numeros army would occupy Kavaro, which is the richest city in Weltluna. It's the best place to colonize and use as a front base to start an invasion. This is what Commander Xenon is planning. Why is he after Ms. Arya? McBain asked. She is probably a descendant of the Water Tribe. Oh yes, we've read about them. What? Says Forte. The Water Tribe are the people who composed the original version of the Water Melody, right? How do you like that? Says McBain. She was healing just by singing, so I was kind of expecting something like that. Forte says, I thought her singing voice sounded similar to the resonance spells from the Lifestone. Palman says, Emperor Rousen is trying to revive and obtain the power of the Water Tribe. Oh. In order to use it as a weapon for the invasion, and Commander Xenon is the one who is carrying out the plan. Very good intel. Awesome. That's what I thought. Something like that. McBain says, I can't believe they even thought about such a thing. Palman says, the technology the Water Tribe possessed is reconstructed to some degree by the Empire, even though it is not perfect. The result is the Wood Soldier. The soldiers who attacked Edel were a detachment force ordered by Commander Xenon. Right. Not rogues or bandits. I think they were called rogues. But they were a detachment force. And of course, had all the military insignia removed and all that such. They just look like they're bandits. I see, says Forte. Now everything's connected. But why did the Wood Soldiers come to the swamp? Asks Una. That I don't know. No. They may have come to kill me under Commander Xenon's orders. Why? Says Una. You're his guy. The more I learned about Arya, the more questions I had toward my duty of the Empire. I guess Commander Xenon didn't like it. That sounds like it, says McBain. Anyway, you go take a rest for a while. Leave Miss Maritos and Mayor DeMille to us. And Arya, too. Mr. McBain. What? When my body starts moving, I'll go to Kavaro right away. Until then, I'll count on you. Alright, let's talk to these guys real quick. So Arya did. I can't believe we were this close to doing something awful. I hate myself now. Using Miss Arya for the Empire's ambition must not happen. Well, I'm glad he didn't die. Gray says, we'll take care of this place. Commander Xenon might target the captain, but we will guard him well. Wow. So they basically... They're going to be considered traitors. Since Commander Xenon seized the army, the numerous empire keeps getting corrupted. Our captain will be the only one who can change their course. Captain is our hope. Anyone else? So that must be Palman's personal tent. He'd be here, but there's no bed here. This is just for like discussing military strategies and such. It's amazing how we could survive after having dealt with so many Wood Soldiers. She might be our Lady Luck. I'm so glad we didn't arrest her. He's keeping watch. The dork. The dork keeps watch. Did I talk to him? Yeah, I did. I talked to you, right? Yep. Alright. So this goes to a dead end. I think. So why does he guard that bridge? That's what fooled me, making me think this was the way out, because he's guarding that bridge. But no one comes from that way. I mean, you'd think he was just guarding a bridge, but the real bridge is here. This is the way back. We take that, right? Or we take this. Wait, what's this way? Looks like we take this way. Oops! I almost hit that thing. We're probably going to end up having to come back to the swamp another time. A fourth time. The cursed swamp of revisiting. So yeah, we're going to be fighting an entire army soon. Alright, I'm gonna call in an episode here. We'll re-enter Kavaro and see what's going on. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.